Hello everyone. Today, we will continue our exploration of authenticated scans using OWASP ZAP. Our focus will be on a different type of authentication, OAuth2. We'll start by examining a sample OAuth2 application. Let's open it in Burp Suite to observe the authentication flow. As you can see, the page displays no options other than the login. Let's navigate to the login page, enter the username and password, and log in. Once logged in, you will see options to add, delete, or report messages, as well as a reports page to view reported messages and the actions taken on them. Let's review the authentication flow in Burp Suite. There are three key requests in this flow. One primary authentication request, this initial request includes the username and password. The server responds with a success status, providing a session token, its expiration time, and other details. To authorization request. This request includes the client ID, session token, redirect URL, and other parameters. If authorization is successful, the server responds with a 302 status code. The 302 response contains the callback URL we have set, along with an authorization code. 3 callback request. The callback URL is accessed with the authorization code received in the second request. The application verifies the authorization code, and if successful, a session cookie is generated. The user is now successfully logged in. This flow diagram outlines the authentication process using Okta. Username and password are passed to the Okta primary authentication endpoint. If authentication is successful, a session token is generated. The session token, client ID, and other details are passed to the Okta authentication endpoint. If all details match, the user is redirected to the callback URL with an authorization code and cookies. The application callback endpoint verifies the authorization code, client ID, and other details. If all details are verified, a session cookie is generated. Open OWASP ZAP to scan an application using OWASP ZAP. Follow these steps. Open ZAP and navigate to the Scripts tab. Select the New Script option. In the New Script window, enter a script name. Select type as authentication. Choose script engine as JavaScript. Select template as the authentication default template in JavaScript. Click Save. The script will now be displayed under the authentication section. Next, we need to assign the parameters and credentials required for the script, which can be modified from the ZAP UI. Add the required parameters. Add the optional parameters. Finally, add the credentials parameters. Define the variables needed to interact with ZAP functions. The main function in this script is the authenticate function. Start by initializing variables and assigning the parameters configured earlier. Build the first request, which is the primary authentication request. For this, you will need the primary authentication endpoint. Username and password, obtained from the parameters. Create the post parameters using the username and password. Use the helper.prepareMessage function to create a new HTTP message. Assign the request body and request header to the first request. Since Okta requires the primary authentication request as a JSO request, add the relevant headers to the request. Use the helper.sendAndReceive method to send an HTTP request and receive the corresponding response. Okta responds with a JSO object, which you can pass to read the success and session token parameters from the response. Once the session token is successfully received from the first request, we will proceed with the second request. Before sending it, however, we will add a message indicating the successful reception of the token to the history tab of the ZAP UI. If needed, you can also store the session token in a variable for future use. In the second request, we need several parameters to construct the URL, including the client ID, redirect URI, session token, and others. As with the first request, we utilize the helper.prepareMessage and helper.sendAndReceive functions to send the HTTP request. Upon receiving the response, we will check if the status code is 302, which indicates that authorization has been successfully completed. If the status code for the second request is 302, we will proceed to the third request. Similar to the second request, we will add a message to the history tab of the ZAP UI. The redirect URL in the response will provide us with the necessary information for the third request, including parameters such as the authorization code and state. At this point, we need to add two new cookies to the request, as required by Okta. These cookies will be similar to the state and nonce parameters we included in the second request. Again, we will use the helper.prepareMessage and helper.sendAndReceive functions to send the HTTP request. To verify the success of the login process, we will analyze the response for a setCookie header. If this header is present, it confirms that the login was successful. We can then extract the cookie details and save them in a variable. These details will allow us to create a cookie for future requests, ensuring that the application remains in a logged-in state. To maintain the logged-in state of the application, we need to add the session cookie to each request. This can be accomplished using an HTTP sender script. Follow these steps to create and configure the script. 1. Create a new script. Select the New Script option. In the New Script window, enter a script name. Set the type to HTTP sender. Choose JavaScript as the script engine. Select HTTP sender default template in JavaScript as the template. Click Save. The script will now appear under the HTTP sender section. 2. Define required variables. To interact with ZAP functions, we need to define variables in the script. The key functions used are sending request and response received. The sending request function allows us to add the cookie to each outgoing request. 3. Script logic. Begin by initializing the necessary variables and assigning the cookie details obtained earlier. Next, check if the request is an authentication request. If it is a normal request and within the scope of the application, proceed with the following steps. Read the existing cookies in the request. Remove any existing cookies, if present. If the request URL is not related to login or logout, add the session cookie to the request. 4. Enable the script. After completing the script, select the Enable Script option to activate the HTTP sender script. By following these steps, the session cookie will be automatically added to each request, ensuring the application remains in a logged-in state. We will now return to the Sites tab to configure a new scan. First, we will run a spider on the URL to identify the accessible URLs. As you can see, the site tree initially shows only the login page. To proceed, we will add the URL to a new context. Next, open the newly created context and navigate to the authentication section. Choose the script-based authentication method. Once selected, the script we created will appear in the Scripts drop-down menu. Click the Load button to associate the script with the context. Now, we can see the parameters defined in the script displayed in the UI. Use the ZAP interface to fill in the necessary details and click Save. To ensure ZAP can initiate the authentication flow when needed, we will add a logged out indicator to the context. To do this, go to the response section and identify the part that appears when a user is logged out. Right-click and select flag as context, then choose the authentication logged out indicator for the context and save. Next, we need to configure the username and password in ZAP. Open the context and navigate to the Users section. Then click the Add button. The credential parameters defined in the script will be automatically displayed. Assign a meaningful name to the user and input the credentials using the ZAP UI. Once done, click Save. Now, navigate to the Forced User section to confirm that the newly created user is selected. Enable Forced User mode in the toolbar to ensure that ZAP uses this user during the scan. With the configuration complete, we are ready to begin the scan. Start by running a spider again. In the spider window, ensure the correct context and user are selected, then click the Start Scan button. ZAP will now crawl the site, and the site tree will display all the accessible URLs. You can monitor the authentication requests and responses in the History tab. Finally, initiate an active scan to assess the application's security. Select the same context and user. Then click the Start Scan button to begin the active scan.